idea that he won't concede the election undermines our democracy. Let's discuss this now with CNN's senior political analyst, Mr. David Gergen, a former advisor to presidents from both parties, Alan Dershowitz, defense attorney, and the author of Electile Dysfunction, A Guide for Unaroused Voters. I have to make sure I say that slowly so that I get it right. And Douglas Brinkley, CNN presidential historian and author of Rightful Heritage, Franklin D. Roosevelt, and The Land of America. Thank you, guys. How are you doing? Did you get any rest after the debate
Absolutely.
Last night and
raring to go.
Dinner? It's really coming down to the wire,
yep.
Right? So Donald Trump defended his rigged election stance today. Listen to this.
If Al Gore or George Bush had agreed 3 weeks before the election to concede the results and waive their right to a legal challenge or a recount, then there would be no Supreme Court case and no Gore versus Bush or Bush versus Gore. And there have been numerous other cases. In effect, I'm being asked to waive centuries of legal precedent designed to protect the voters.
Alan, you would know a lot about that because you were involved in Bush v. Gore.
That's
so
right.
Is Trump on solid ground here?
Oh, of course not. Clearly, what happened there is there was a recount. Remember, the case is called Bush versus Gore, not Gore versus Bush.
Right.
There were lawsuits filed by both of them. That's a legitimate challenge. Everybody understands that. Look, what Trump's doing is talking to two audiences. To his audience, to his group, he's saying, I will not accept the election because Don Lemon has rigged it with the rest of the media and will not accept this. To the media, he spins it and says, I wasn't talking about that. I was talking about only if there is a legal challenge. So he's talking to two different constituencies.
Yeah. So I'm watching this last night and this morning, and the surrogates and the campaign people, and they're like doing cartwheels and backflips.
Sure.
And I'm like, what are they talking about? I mean, that's a whole lot of spinning going on, Douglas Brinkley. Do you think that that's a fair comparison? You know, because a lot of people are comparing this to the Bush episode.
Well, absolutely not. It's crazy for Donald Trump to be talking like that. I mean, Al Gore did something. You know, if it, actually Al Gore had conceded to George W. Bush, then found out the Florida problem, held back a little, and then there was a recount. And then he very graciously became quite heroic, Al Gore, the way he accepted the Supreme Court decision. So Trump's mixing apples and oranges in here, and I have no idea why he thinks this rigged argument is going to help him win the presidency, but he's embarrassing our country internationally. I mean, free and fair elections are our bread and butter around the world, and here Donald Trump is saying we don't know how to do them.
Mr. Gergen, why are they doing this? I mean, why him and then his folks?
My sense is that Donald Trump is not trying to win the election. He's trying to not lose. And what he's trying to do is set up an excuse for when he loses. I think he feels, his campaign feels, this is going to be very difficult to pull out. So he's preparing the ground to tell people it's illegitimate. But in that same way, what you do is you delegitimize the winner and Hillary Clinton, and you try to make her like she's not appropriately there. So many of his followers now believe she would wind up in the wrong house. She ought to be in the jailhouse, in their view, not the White House. Mm-hmm. And that creates conditions where it makes it very, very difficult for Republicans to cooperate across the aisle with her. You're cooperating with the devil. You're cooperating with this criminal type figure. It also, frankly, encourages people to think maybe we ought to take her out. And we have heard that now from some Trump supporters. That's an extraordinarily dangerous situation. And it is debasing our democracy and our faith and institutions in ways we don't need any more of this. All our institutions are in trouble already. And if you begin to think elections are all rigged, you know, then we're not a nation anymore at that point. We're just a group of people fighting with each other.
I'm sitting here listening to you guys who've been around. I mean, you know, I'm an older person. I'm a man of a certain age. But you guys have been around longer than I have and have been dealing with this. And I'm listening to the severity of what you're saying, David Gergen. You've worked for both Democrats and for Republican presidents. As we have an historian here. We have an attorney. Every single person is saying there is no merit to any of this. I don't understand why his supporters believe it and why he continues to do it. And then he pushes back and says, it's the liberal media. No, it's not. It's the truth.
Mm-hmm. And then at the same time, in the debate, he says yesterday that she shouldn't even be allowed to run. And then at the Al Smith dinner, he jokes about pardoning her. I mean, here is a guy who is on the verge of himself being indicted over Trump University. And, you know, there's a case where he might very well, if he weren't running for president, end up being indicted. And he's trying to challenge the president of the United States. When she becomes president, he will do to her what he tried to do to Barack Obama when he tried to challenge Obama's legitimacy for not having been born in the United States.
Well, speaking of the Obamas, let me just play this because I want you guys to respond to this. And first, Douglas, you, and then I'll let David in. This is the First Lady today on Donald Trump.
We are fortunate to live in a country where the voters decide our elections. The voters decide who wins and loses, period, end of story. And when a presidential candidate threatens to ignore our voices and reject the outcome of this election, he is threatening the very idea of America itself.
Douglas, the very idea of America itself?
I agree with her completely. I just think the First Lady had to endure Donald Trump saying that her husband is an illegitimate president, that he wasn't born in the United States. She had to live through all the birther BS, and now they're having to deal with the fact that if Hillary Clinton wins, Donald Trump's going to say she's a phony president too. Hillary Clinton is very blessed to have surrogates like Barack Obama and Michelle Obama. Michelle went to Arizona. The president went to Florida today. She could take part of the day off, prepare for the Al Smith dinner, and they hit it out of the park today. They're two of their best speeches, political speeches, an endorsement of Hillary Clinton, I've heard, and they both happened this afternoon.
Yeah, there are other Republicans who are speaking out as well, including